Hey guys, this is HD Video Tuts here, also known as Joy in real life, and today we're going to learn a little bit of Java, just enough to get you started. So we're going to go to File, click New. This is Eclipse, by the way. You can also do it on NetBeans, and if you're an absolute beginner and you don't have an IDE, go ahead and look for a tutorial on how to install Eclipse or NetBeans. We're going to go ahead and click Create New Java Project. Cool. All right. Click here. Right click on the SRC and click hover over new and create class. We're gonna name it package. Cool. And we're gonna name this class. Let's just call it mushroom. All right. Boom. So we have a public class mushroom, and all of our code is going to go in here. So we're going to go ahead and create a public static void main string args and it's showing us an error. All right, so we have run into our first problem, and it's a good thing because we can learn about Java that way. So how Java works is everything needs to be case sensitive. So certain commands, certain words, such as string, needs to be capitalized, unless you'll get an error. All right, so this is where all your code will go, under this, under your public static void main string. Args, all right. So all code goes here. Just remember that. So we're gonna create a simple program that tells people your age. I mean, that displays your age and your name in a sentence. Okay. So we're gonna create our first variable. So now we're gonna declare a variable called my name, and the first letter of your second word needs to be capitalized. That's how it works in Java. Now my name, we know my name is a variable, but what type of variable is it? We're going to declare it as a string. Okay, and sorry about that, it needs to be a string, capitalized, boom. It's still giving you that error, but that means it's not used, but that's because we haven't used it yet. We are going to use it though. So we can also declare more than one variables, but let me show you how to declare a value for the variable. So the equal sign is known as the assignment operator, and the plus sign, just like the plus sign, is known as the addition operator, right? So assignment means you're assigning something to this my name thing, my name variable. And so when we assign a string, it needs to be in quotes, so we can assign, let's say, Joy. All right, that's because that's my name, right? So my name, I'm assigning my name as Joy, and we can assign my state equal to New York. All right, now because these two are on the same line as this and we have a comma going on here, Java recognizes that my state is also a string. All right, now we're going to explain what an int is. So int is my age. Int is basically any positive number. It's an integer. All right, just look up what an integer is. If you understand basic math, you'll know what an integer is. And so I'm going to say my age is 19, and it's gonna say it's never used, blah 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 blah, we haven't used it yet. And so we're gonna start using it. All right, so you're already coding in Java, right? All right, and you have already learned than you have learned in class, probably, unless you have a really good professor. So now we're gonna go ahead and use these variables. These variables are useless unless you can use them, right? So we're gonna go ahead and say, we're gonna go ahead and type in system.out.print system.out.print parentheses arguments, and always end with a semicolon. Always end with a semicolon, right? Now, what this is saying is system.out.print. It means system.out is saying it's an output, and I want to print something. Basically, I want to type something. All right, what if I want to type my name is, and then I'm going to type in my name. Is it going to work? It's not going to work. Let me show you why. It's not going to work, right? That's because we're saying Java is confused about what to print. Should it print this or should it print this? Well, we want to tell him, I want you to print both. So you're going to go ahead and add the plus sign, and now it's going to print both. It's saying my name is Joy, but you see how there's no space? So you need to add a space here. So it's going to say, my name is Joy, right? That's cool, right? You're doing something cool already. And we actually want to give this print line so that it skips a line. Right after this, it's going to skip a line because we have the print line command, ln. It's actually print ln, stands for print line. So also second line, we want to type system.out.print. I am how many years old? So I'm going to type in my age. Remember to add the plus sign. Now, watch what happens when I do this. Oops, I forgot to add the semicolon. The S needs to be capitalized, by the way. Print line. This is, it's going to skip a line after this. So it's basically after this, whatever I type in this box, it's going to go to the next, it's going to go to the next line. Let me explain. System.out.print, I am years old. I am my age, and you're going to type years old. Old. Comma R. I live in plus my state. So go ahead and type that. And sorry about the police sirens if you can hear them. So let me show you how this works. Ah, that space. So I'm going to add a space before years old. All right. It says, my name is Joy, right? We have a print line command here. So after this, it goes to a new line. It says, print I am my age. So I am 19. But it doesn't, although we have, although we have years old, I live in, my state is in a new line. Because we didn't add print ln here, it's not going to skip a line. It's going to just keep typing on the same line, but whatever is after this, it's going to come on a new line. So because we have a print ln command, so whatever is after my name comes on a new line. So yeah, that's how it works. I'm going to add a space here. So I'll run it again. Yeah, my name is Joy. I'm 19 years old. And I live in New York. Boom. So that's the gist of how variables work in Java. But what if you wanted the people to be able to tell you what they want? I mean, what their names are. So you want to say, you want people to be enter names, right? So for that, you would need to import the scanner utility. So that would be import Java, I think, dot util scanner. Please tell me I'm right. Am I right? Okay, yeah, it imported. So we're gonna go ahead and create a new line, create a new thing called scanner. So this is a new variable, all right? Scanner, we're gonna call it sc equals new scanner system, capitalize the S, system dot in. All right. And instead of saying string my name is equal to Joy, I'm gonna just let the people enter their name. So we're gonna leave it as blank. We're just gonna define it as string. And make sure you've got that comma going on there. And int my age. We're gonna say, all right. So S is a scanner, we're saying my name and my state is going to be a string, basically words, and my age is going to be an integer, which is a number. That's all we're going to say. And now we want people to enter their name, all right? So first things first, we're going to go ahead and type in system. We're going to ask people for their name. So let's enter a new line, system.out.println, and we're going to type in what is your name ? And now we gotta tell the program to basically take in whatever they enter as their name. So we're going to say, because our scanner is sc, we're going to type in sc dot next line, boom, that's all. And make sure you have a semicolon going on here. I always forget that semicolon. Please do not forget that semicolon. It will ruin your life. It will ruin your relationships, I'm telling you. All right, so now it knows that sc.nextLine, whatever is in that next line, now we gotta make it equal to our name. So we're gonna type in my name equals. So whatever you type in on the next line from the scanner SC, scanner basically means your keyboard. Whatever you type in using your keyboard on that next line is gonna be equal to my name. And basically we're gonna do the same exact thing for everything. So we're gonna type in system.out dot print line print ln what is your age damn it, I always forget that semicolon. So my age is equal to sc dot next line. Always make sure you capitalize that. Actually, it's not going to be next line. It's going to be next int because it's an integer. So capitalize that I. Make sure you add that parentheses because that's how it works. And you're set. And now you want to ask people, what state do you live in? System.out.print. Print line, what state do you live in? Boom. And so my state is going to be equal to sc dot next line. All right, let me explain this a few things. So next line basically means we use it for next, if it's a string, basically words. And next int we use basically if it's a number. All right, that's all you need to know for now. For absolute beginners, this is just for getting into things. You'll be fine with this. Let's run our code. All right, it's asking us, what is our name? My name is Joy. What is your age? I am 19. You never asked out for, how come it didn't ask me for my age? Crap. All right, this is weird. Where did we mess up? You know what? It's glitching out, so maybe if we move this code and move it right here, maybe that'll help. All right, saying, my name is Joy, I'm 19 years old, and I live in New York. All right, let's run this again. See, now that worked. Maybe it was because next int and then we switched to next line, it got confused. So let's just run this again. And I'm going to say my name is Kevin this time. And what state do you live in? I live in Kentucky. Is Kentucky a state? And I am 55 years old. My name is Kevin, I'm 55 years old, and I live in Kentucky. So that's how you do that. Now, let's learn about if and else on the next tutorial.